Hello students, this is the solved answer of the question given by me on last class. So you can have a look here. Check your answer from my answers and then do chemistry fair. You can show your homework and also the chemistry fair on my personal WhatsApp number. So have a look. So student, your next physical property of matter is, matter exists in three different states, that is solid, liquid and gas. Now what is the reason the matter shows three different states? It is due to the variation in the characteristic of particles of matter. That means there are variations in the arrangement of particles of matter and also variations in the force of attractions between them, as I discussed to you before also. So we will separately discuss the properties of solid, liquid and gases. Now first we'll see the properties of solids. Solids have definite shape, distinct boundaries, fixed volumes and have negligible compressibility. They have very low compressibility. It is because the particles of the solids are held together very close to each other. We can take one example also. The shape of solid like sugar and salt crystals remain fixed whether you take it in your hand or pour it in plate or in jars. They never change their shape, they retain their shape. Now the second property of solid is, solids have tendency to maintain their shapes even subjected to outside forces. Even though outside forces are applied to the solids, they do not change their shapes. So solids are said to be rigid. That means solid may break under force when excessive force is applied, but it is difficult to change its shape. Here also we can take one example of rubber. Rubber band changes its shape under force, that is when it is stretched, but regains its original shape when the force is removed. But if frequent force or excessive force is applied to the rubber band, it may break. Now next property of solid is, some solids are compressible. As I discussed in first point that solids have a low compressibility, but there are some solids in our environment who are compressible. For example, a sponge. A sponge has minute holes in it in which air is trapped. So when we press the sponge, as you can see in the diagram here, you can see the sponge, it has minute hole in it in which air is trapped and filled. But when we press the sponge, the air inside it is expelled out and we can compress it further. So we can say that there are some solids which can be compressible. Now, your next property is solid particles are capable of diffusing with each other very slowly. That is, not in a very easy way. This is because the particles are very tightly packed in solids and only vibration of particles happens on the spot rather than moving from one place to another. As I explained you the diffusion definition, that diffusion is nothing but the intermixing of the particles of two different types of matter on their own. So the solid particles can diffuse, but they diffuse very slowly. We call intercellular spaces between the particles of solids are very less. So they have very less vacant space in which solid particles get into the space of the another solid particles. Hence, the diffusion is very slow in solid particles. Now, your next topic, next point is, solid particles can diffuse into liquid particles more easily. As you can see in the diagram, a liquid particles are loosely arranged and there are enough vacant space in which the solid particles get into it and diffuse. That is why we say that solid particles can diffuse into liquid particles more easily as that of the solid-solid particles. Now, the next point is, the next property of solid is, on heating or on rising the temperature, the vibration of particles increases and solid expand. What do you mean by vibration, students? Vibration is nothing but the shaking or to or fro motion of the particles. So when we rise the temperature, the particles to and fro motion increases. That means the speed of particle increases and hence the solid expands. So these are some of the properties of the solid that you have to study. Next is the properties of liquid. First property of liquid is, liquids have no fixed shape and size, but they have fixed volume. It is because the particles are not tightly packed as solid. They are loosely arranged. That's why they have no fixed shape. We can be more clear by taking one example. If we take 50 ml of a liquid and transfer into different containers one by one, we observe that the liquid takes the shape of the container in which it is kept or poured, but the volume of liquid, that is 50 ml that we took, remains fixed in every container. So we can say that liquids have a fixed volume, but it does not have fixed shape because it takes the shape of the container in which it is poured. Next property, liquids are not rigid as solid because the particles of liquid are not densely packed as solid. Third property is, liquid are called fluids. Why they are called fluids? Because they flow and change shape. Next property is, liquid particles can diffuse more easily than solids. This is because of the same reason that particles in liquid move freely because of greater space between the particles in liquid. Next property is, solid, liquid and gases all can diffuse into liquid more easily. than as that of the solid. But the rate of diffusion is different. Here, the gases diffuse, gas particle diffuse more faster in liquid than the liquid particles in liquid and than the solid particles in liquid. Hence, we can say that the rate of diffusion is greater in gases, gas liquid, than the liquid liquid and than the solid liquid. We can also see the diffusion occurring in our surrounding. For example, atmospheric gases like oxygen and carbon dioxide dissolve in water, which is essential for the survival of the aquatic animals and plants. And dissolved oxygen in water help in breathing aquatic animals. Now, next property of liquid is liquids are more compressible than solids because the particles in liquid are loosely arranged. That's why they can be compressed. Now, next property of liquid is on heating, the vibration of particles in liquid increase and liquids expand. You can see in the diagram, the liquid particles are arranged like this. They have some vacant space between them. But when we rise the temperature or when we heat the liquid, the expansion of the particles happens. So you can see here, the particles become more far away from each other and they have now more vacant spaces between them. So we can say that liquid expansion took place here. Next is the properties of gases. Gases have no fixed shape, size and volume, but they have fixed mass. This is because the particles in gases are very loosely arranged as compared to the liquids and solids. So they are not rigid and they do not have fixed shape and size. We'll be more clear by taking one example. If we have LPG gas filled in a gas cylinder, then at that time the volume of the LPG gas is equal to the volume of gas cylinder. Now if we release whole LPG gas in the room, then the LPG gas occupies the whole area of the room and at that time the volume of LPG gas will be equal to the volume of the room and shape of the gas is that of the room only. So the gases do not have fixed volume. They spread themselves in the container they remain. Now the second property is they are highly compressible as compared to liquid and solids. This is because of the same reason that particles in gases have much more vacant spaces between them. So they can be compressed easily. Examples, large volume of LPG gas can be compressed in small cylinders. Also CNG gas is stored in gas cylinder and used as a fuel for vehicles. Also helium and hydrogen gases are also stored in cylinder and are used for filling balloons or inflating the balloons. Now next property is rate of diffusion in gases are faster than in liquid and solid. This is because of the reason that they have high speed of particles and larger spaces between the particles in gases. Now next property is on heating the vibration of gas particles increase and gas expands. We can see the diagram here. You can see the gas particles they move faster, they are in large motion. On heating the gas particle becomes more far away from each other. And you can see the more empty spaces between them. Hence, we can say that on heating, the gas particles expand. Now, next property is gas exert the pressure. Why do gas exert the pressure? It is because of the high speed of the gas particles. The particles of gases move faster, and due to their random movement of the particles hit each other and also hit the wall of the container. If we assume this is the wall of the container in which particles are there, so because of their high speed and enough vacant spaces between them, they move and hit each other, hit their neighboring particles, and also hit the wall of the container. Due to this random hitting and collision, gases exert the pressure. And you must know that as the collision or hitting of this particle increase, then the pressure of gas also increase. Hence, we can define pressure exerted by the gases is actually the force exerted by the gas particles per unit area on the wall of the container. So, this is about the properties of gases. So, till now we discussed the properties of different states of matter, that is solids, liquids and gases. Now, you should also know some terms which would help you to solve the questions that would be given by me at the time of online class. Now, what are these terms? The first one is density. Density is mass per unit volume of a substance. How do you define it mathematically? So, density is mass by volume. So, as mass of a substance increases, density also increases, because density is directly proportional to mass. Keeping the mass constant, if a volume of gas increases, then density automatically decreases, and vice versa. It is because the density is inversely proportional to volume. Okay. Now, solids have generally high density as compared to liquids. Generally, they have high density. But gases have low density as compared to liquids and gases. Now, what would be the density of water? So, in terms of gram per cubic centimeter, it is 1 gram per cubic centimeter, or per cmq, you can say. You can also calculate in kg per meter cube. You can see down there I have written density of water is 1000 kg per cubic meter. What is the density of ice? Density of ice is 0.919 gram per cubic centimeter. You can also calculate in terms of kg per meter cube. You can also see down, extreme down here. Here density of water, density of ice is 990 kilogram per cubic meter. Now you have some terms to define. First is rigidity. Rigidity is a property of solid to resist the change in its shape. As we all know that solid do not change its shape because of its property called rigidity. Now, compressibility. What is compressibility? Compressibility is a property of a fluid like liquid or gas, due to which its volume decreases when pressure is applied. So, hence we know that liquid and gases are highly compressible as compared to solids. Some of the solids are also compressible. Now, the next definition is fluidity. Fluidity of is the ability of liquid or gas to flow. Simple definition. Now, next is filling a gas container means what? It means when a gas container is filled with large amount of gas, when the external pressure is applied on a gas while filling. What does it mean? A gas container can be filled with large amount of gas when external pressure is applied on a gas while filling. Here what happens? Gas particles are compressed into a small volume in gas cylinders or gas containers. Okay, so is it visible? Okay. Now, what is kinetic energy? The energy which a body possesses by virtue of its motion is called kinetic energy. So you also know that rising the temperature, kinetic energy of particles in solid, liquid or gases increase. So it's like that. Now we'll see the shape. What we can talk about shape? A solid have definite shape because the particles in solids are tightly arranged. They are very closely arranged, compactly arranged. Okay. So these are some of the definitions.